Hey everybody, today we're going to be talking about gaps and overlaps in No Place Left. And the reason why we need to talk about this is because we are being so aggressive at spreading the gospel that we're beginning to run into one another, and so we need to address gaps and overlaps. So we want to be aggressive and fill the gaps, but we also need to be cautious of overlaps. So first, a story. When I was at Fort Benning, we had five teams that had areas of responsibility in order to strategically reach the whole post. And so we had Sand Hill out here. We had Kelly Hill up here. We had Main Post. We had the Airborne School where they trained paratroopers. And then we had the 3rd Battalion of the 75th Ranger Regiment here. So the teams wanted to make sure that we were strategically reaching all these areas. So we sat down and we assigned these areas to different people and different teams. And so everybody was happy until one day some guys from Team 4 went and did evangelism in Team 5's area. And the guys on Team 5 found out about this. Now, that may seem like a small thing, but this is Team 5's territory. And so they got a little bit upset about that. And the guys on Team 4, they didn't get the memo. They weren't in the meeting. So they were just being aggressive and doing evangelism in Team 5's area. So we had a meeting. And two things came out of the meeting. We realized that you cannot stop the gospel. It's going to flow everywhere. And so we need to be careful not to make solid lines in these different territories geographically. And what we decided to do was, instead of having a hard, fast territory, these were dotted lines. And the gospel primarily flows through relationships, not by territory or positions, the team's positions in that territory. So we drew them in dotted lines, but we also made sure that, hey, if you're here and you're gonna go over here and do evangelism, at least let these guys know what you're doing. So a high level of communication in order to be sensitive to your brothers in that area. So instead of drawing solid lines, we drew dotted lines. And what we also decided is that we'd hold all our relationships with an open hand, that God is the one who puts them in and God is the one who takes them out. So all our relationships were held with an open hand. On the other hand, we're making sure that we're sensitive to our brother, that we're talking to them about when we begin to reach people in their area. You know, a couple of passages come to my mind when I think about gaps and overlap. The first one is the parable of the kingdom in Matthew 13. 33. Jesus is comparing the kingdom to yeast or leaven that, once it's put into the flour, It begins to leaven the whole lump. And so the gospel, just like the kingdom, will spread unless we start putting bottlenecks, like drawing strong boundaries for people to stay in. If we just let the gospel do what it's meant to do in the kingdom of God, it's just going to spread everywhere. And we need to be aware of that. So the kingdom spreads freely. The next verse that comes to my mind is John the Baptist and Jesus' relationship and how they did this. You notice in John chapter 1, verse 35 through 51, Jesus has been introduced to the new disciples by John the Baptist. He says, "Behold, the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world." When he does that, he loses two of his best disciples to Jesus. And so we see John the Baptist being open-handed with the people that God has given him. And oh, by the way, they belong to Jesus anyways. Now, if you pay close attention, you notice that Jesus and John the Baptist never team up, so to speak, and have the same ministry. They're separate, but people are flowing back and forth. People from John's ministry are coming and talking to Jesus, and John doesn't have a problem with that. One last scripture reference. In Mark chapter 9, 38 and 39, John the apostle makes this interesting statement to Jesus. He says, "Jesus, there's some guys out there. They're casting out demons. They're doing a work in your name. And we told them, hey, you need to stop that because you're not with us. You're not part of the 12. And Jesus said, "Don't do that. If they are not speaking against me, then they certainly won't come against me later. So leave those guys alone. Let them do their thing." And so one of the things that we realize is that we don't have to all be uniform. We have to be unified, but we don't have to be uniform. And we'll see the kingdom of God spread a lot quicker if we're just open-handed but sensitive to our brother and communicate. And then we can be as aggressive as we want to cover down on these gaps, knowing that we'll have overlap.